When writing music, it is important to be able to manipulate the emotions of your listeners. This can be done through many means, but harmony is the most direct way. As an example, listen to this chord progression and make a mental note of how it makes you feel. Here's another. And finally, just one more example. Now I cheated here. I said that I was going to make you feel emotion through the chords, but the first do have a rhythm to them that highlights the intended mood. The first has a quicker, carefree rhythm that emphasizes its happiness, while the second has a slower rhythm that is meant to contribute to its sadness. So even though harmony is very important for mood, rhythm adds another layer of complexity. All right, cool. But what about this melancholy chord that you saw in the title? Well, the last chord progression features it. Let me play it again. You hear the chord on bar three? I did not add rhythm to this progression, for it is already powerful enough. Now I shall explain how this chord works, show examples of it through genres, and tell you how it can be used when composing. All right, how does this chord work? Why does it evoke the emotions that it does? And what is its purpose? First of all, this melancholy chord is the minor fourth chord of the major scale. I'll use C major as an example. Because we are using the fourth, our root would be F. Then we would go up a minor third, then a major third to complete the chord. This chord is not normally found in C major. If you stuck directly to the scale, you would get F major instead. In relation to C major, F minor sounds distant and somber. It gives off a strong feeling of sadness. In the chord progression, it works similarly. It can be used to temporarily tone down the brightness before the harmony picks up its lightness once more. Or it can be used to gracefully and somberly end a progression. The latter is used more commonly, especially with the common major 4 to minor 4 to major 1 movement that is used in practically every genre, but especially pop. The melancholy chord is the minor fourth chord of a major scale and can be used in a variety of ways to bring a bit of darkness to a chord progression. Next up, here are some examples that use this chord and what we can learn from them. I'll start with a song that most people would recognize, In My Life by the Beatles. After the intro, the main chord progression is introduced. We start on the tonic, of course, then the seventh is added for some extra spice. After that, the harmony moves up to the major fourth chord before gently transitioning to the minor fourth chord. This is the most common way of using the melancholy chord, being right after the major fourth chord. It creates chromatic movement between the thirds of the two chords, in this case, F sharp to F. From there, it resolves on the tonic, with the F from earlier going down another half step to E. This chromatic movement helps to emphasize the minor fourth chord, making it stand out more and call to the listener. The major fourth to minor fourth to tonic chord progression is very common, and the Beatles love to use it. The major fourth chord is expected, with nothing fancy about it, but just by lowering the third by a semitone, the mood changes drastically. And due to the third being one semitone away from the one chord's fifth, and the melancholy chord's tonic being half a step away from the root's third, it creates a smooth transition back to home base. Overall, the one to major fourth to minor fourth to one progression is something that any aspiring composer should learn. Ah yes, the bringer of peace, a part of Gustav Holst's The Planet Venus is truly something wonderful. Her peaceful yet eerie and bittersweet feeling makes her distinct from Mars and Mercury that surround her. Rich chords are used most of the time, however the minor four chord is still implemented despite this. At about the middle of the piece, the richness of the chords is temporarily toned down, allowing for more simple but equally moving harmony to come into play. The chords, which are being led by a simple melody, fall from the tonic to the minor fourth. However, it's not the regular minor fourth chord. It has an added sixth. In the key of A major, this would be D minor 6, a slightly brighter version of the melancholy chord, but still haunting nonetheless. After a repeat of this figure and something's happening in between, it falls upon the melancholy chord once more, this time with the bass line boldly staying on the tonic. The way the chord is used in this piece is very notable. It commands the listener's presence, but is not forceful in doing so. It is done in an unpredictably expected way that leaves the listener wanting more, but Gustav Holst, being a genius, refrains from doing so. The last example I will be using is from Star Wars. Princess Leia's theme is soft yet dramatic, and the minor four chord is the main contributing factor to that. After a short intro, the main melody and harmony is introduced. As usual, the one chord starts us off, but then it immediately transitions to the minor four chord. This movement is highlighted even more by the melody moving to the fourth of the scale, the tonic of the melancholy chord. The melody then moves down to the second degree, increasing the tension. This tension is released as the chord moves back to the one chord, only to transition to the minor 4 chord once again. And this time the melody goes higher, taking the flat 6 as its position, the third of the minor 4th chord. This way of using the minor 4 chord is the most cinematic in my opinion. The stark transition between the home chord and the minor 4 chord creates a feeling of suspension like no other. And when repeated, its effects hardly diminish when used carefully. And even though this video is not about melody, the way John Williams composes intertwines the melody and harmony very closely, of course. So when using this chord, you should pay attention to the melody, as creating dissonance through the melody must be done carefully. As I have said repeatedly, this chord is mainly used to darken a progression. So if you want your song to be light, then don't use it. But if you aren't afraid to add some melancholy to your progressions, then go right ahead. As seen through the examples, there are three main ways of implementing this chord. The first is to put it right after the major 4 chord, something heard a lot in pop music. This is most commonly done with the 1 to 4 to minor 4 to 1 progression, but by taking another progression, like the 1 to minor 6 to major 4 to 5, and then changing it to the 1 to minor 6 to minor 4 to 1 can work extremely well. The next technique does not involve using the minor 4 chord exactly how it is, but instead adding more color to it. In the key of C major, F minor 6 is the pinnacle example of this. Adding more color to this chord gives it more character. Just be careful not to overdo it, for it will lose the melancholy effect with too many extensions. And finally, as seen in Princess Leia's theme, there is another simple progression that can be used with this chord. The 1 to minor 4 movement is extremely simple, but when done right, it evokes a truly melancholic feeling. It is a stark transition that brings the chord right out. And don't forget how the melody interacts with this chord as well. Overall, always consider the use of these techniques when composing with this chord. The melancholy chord, being the minor 4 chord in a major key, creates a feeling of deep sadness that cannot be recreated through other means. It has seen use in pop music, classical music, film scores, and much more. It is also incredibly versatile, with many uses that are tried and true. A timeless chord.